وحدي صبورا مستعينا بالصلاة.
كم مرة عصف الأنين بداخلي، كم مرة قد ذاك.
بشكل عام الوارد في الحديث عن تربة الإمام الحسين عليه السلام كثير، ورد في قضية تحنيك الطفل روايات أنه يستحب تحنيك الطفل بماء الفرات وبشيء من تراب قبر الحسين عليه السلام.
روايات صحيحة؟
أي روايات معتبرة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How is everyone doing this evening? It's Brother Haji coming to you on his channel with another episode of our Karbala series. So we're on now part 6. We've completed 5. We all know when a Muslim has been blessed with a child, the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is to perform tahniq. Now tahniq is when you chew a date and mix your saliva with that date and place it in the mouth of the newborn child. So what I'm going to do is, before presenting the shocking narrations from the Shia who have totally replaced this sunnah, I'm going to clarify what we have in our books, which is authentic, which is the correct method of performing tahniq. So this is Sahih Bukhari under the chapter of Kitab al-Aqiqah and the hadith number 5469. Asma bint Abi Bakr narrates that she was pregnant in Mecca, and when they left to go to Medina, so she was pregnant with Abdullah ibn Zubair, and when she left to go to Medina, she said she gave birth in Quba. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came and he called for a date, and he chewed it, put his saliva on it, so he placed it in the mouth of Abdullah ibn Zubair radiallahu anhu. So Asma ibn Abi Bakr radiallahu anha said, فَكَانَ أَوَّلَ شَيْءٍ دَخَلَ جَوْفَهُ رِيقُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ ثُمَّ حَنَّكَهُ بِتَمْرَتِهِ. So the first thing that entered the mouth of Abdullah ibn Zubair radiallahu anhu was the saliva and the mixture of the tamar that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam chewed. And he did tahniq with the date. So Sahih al-Bukhari. So the hadith I'm going to read is in Sahih Muslim, but this is the sharh of Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah. So this is narrated by Abi Musa. Qala wulida li ghulamun, that I had a son born. Fasammuhu Ibrahim, and he named him Ibrahim. Fahannakahu bitamratin, and he did tahniq with a date. So he did the ritual where he mixed the saliva with the date and placed it in the mouth of the newborn child. So quite clearly, it's a sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to place a date mixed with saliva in the child's mouth. Now Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah explains this, and he says, the scholars are in agreement upon recommendation of tahniq of a newborn baby at the time of his birth with a date. So if there is no date, then you should replace it with something sweet. The Shia oppose the Sunnah generally because they have taken and have accepted liars of Kufa to narrate virtues, to narrate narrations which the Ahlul Bayt haven't said. And this is why you rarely find a Shia, or Shia narrations rather, present a hadith from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The bulk and the majority of the ahadith are from Abi Abdullah alayhi salam and Imam Baqir alayhi salam. Not many ahadith are from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So those who were narrating ahadith from Imam Baqir alayhi salam, Imam Ja'far alayhi salam, opposed the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So no doubt in this series thus far, from the 5-part series thus far, we presented many fabrications that have been attributed to the noble Imam. Now let's present to you what the Shia have actually done and how they've replaced the noble sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to something totally strange and totally unacceptable. This is Al-Jami'u Lil-Kutub Al-Arba'a, and this is Tahdib Al-Ahkam by Tusi. So the hadith is narrated by Hussein bin Abi A'la. So this individual stated that he heard Abu Abdullah alayhi salam say, "Hanniku awladakum biturbatin Hussein, fa innaha amanun." Do tahniq of your children with the soil of Hussein radhiyallahu anhu, for in it is security. Now the sunnah is to do tahniq with dates or something similar to a date, something sweet. It is never the case that it was from this prophetic sunnah to do tahniq of your newborn children with the dust. So this is not from the sunnah at all. This is not from the sunnah of the messenger alayhi salatu wassalam. The narration that's in Tahdhib al-Ahkam is also in Kamil al-Ziyarat. And this is under hadith number 708. And it's the exact same narration that's in Tahdhib al-Ahkam. Okay? So, I don't know what to really say in connection to this abandonment of a prophetic sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, some might argue, well, we haven't abandoned it. We've also got this option as well. Now, this clearly is opposing the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, once the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam utilized a soil or dust from a grave in order to perform tahniq, I've got your arguments covered, just in case you say, well, you're talking about the turba of Hussein radiallahu anhu. Don't you know about your scholars, what they've said about the turba or the soil of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Yes, we do know. And just to let you know, I know. Ashifa of Qadi Iyad, we know this. So, at the end of the day, don't think we don't know. But even if you use that argument, they didn't use it to do tahniq of newborn children. And even if you present that to us, we'll say that's an opinion of a scholar. That's his scholarly right. If he feels that way, we don't say this is narrated. We don't say this is from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam or his companions. We say that it's an opinion of a scholar, very, very highly respected, and that's his opinion. But your infallible imam is apparently taught by Ali radiallahu anhu, who was taught by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So where did he get this practice from? Where was he inspired by the Ahlul Bayt in terms of a sunnah or a practice that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't do ever in his lifetime? Never. So rest assured, this is a bid'ah. This is an absolute innovation, an evil innovation that has no basis in Islam, to use soil of the turba of Hussein radiallahu anhu to welcome a newborn child into the earth. Ridiculous, absolute nonsense. Now, let's take it a step further. Let's take this a step further. We've already introduced this un-Islamic practice, this disgusting bid'ah, into the religion, which has no prophetic backing. Let's see what else you've done. Back to Tahdhib al-Ahkam again. Al-Jami'u lil-Kutub al-Arba'ah is narrated by Abi Ja'far, which is Imam Baqir alayhi salam. Yuhanniku al-mawludu bima'i al-furati. That perform tahniq of your newborn with the water of the Euphrates. Already done a two-part series for the Euphrates River, meaning in connection to the Karbala series. And there's another narration underneath that says, Hanniku awladakum bima'i al-furati. You do tahniq of your newborn children by the river Euphrates, by the water of the river Euphrates, and the dust and the soil of Hussein. So you mix both of them together and you do tahniq of your newborn children. That is totally opposing the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I don't know what to say, to be honest. And to add another narration on top of this, in Wasa'il al-Shi'a by Hur al-Amali, same narration. So this is part 6. Part 7, it's also in connection to the turba of Hussein radiallahu anhu. How they've elevated this turba. And rest assured, all your answers in relation to as-salat and, you know, praying on the earth will be settled in part 7. I've got everything sorted for you. So it split into two separate parts for the turba of Hussein radiallahu anhu. And I will elaborate this in part 7. So here's all the evidences of youth for part 6. Okay? Here you go. Part 7 would follow in about another week or two. And you won't want to believe what else they use this turba for. And what they conceal from you as well in relation to what this turba also entails. What this turba, what special powers this turba has. So rest assured you're going to see everything in part 7. Everything will be revealed in part 7. So part 6 is done. Wait for part 7. Wait for part 7. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد.
كم مرة عصف الأنين بداخلي، كم مرة قد ذاق قلبي من أسى رحلتها، وكم كرهت مصابها، لكن رأيت الخير يسكب في أنا. كم مرة قد ضقت من عظم البلاء، بشر وشيطان يحاصرني أبا. كم مرة قد أظلم الدرب وتحدر الدمع وضاقت بي رؤى.